Welcome to Antenna and Wave Propagation playlist. Here, in this session, I'll be going to explain effective height of antenna. So, in this session, I'll be explaining effective height of antenna. So, basically, before we proceed to this session, let us have presentation outline for this session. So, in this session, I'll be explaining you how we need to understand effective height of antenna in radiation of antenna. Then I'll explain how to calculate that with respect to current distribution. And then after, I'll explain comparison of two dipole antenna with its calculation of effective height of antenna. So then after, it will be clear to all like what is that which is there with effective height of antenna. So basically, when we talk about effective height of antenna, it is giving clear indication of how much effective radiation that happens by antenna. So when we talk about effective height of antenna, that gives indication of effective radiation by antenna. So effective height of antenna gives indication of effective radiation by antenna. So what does that mean? And how to calculate that? So for that, I am just considering one example where here I have one dipole, and that dipole is having length L is equals to lambda by 2. So over here, if I say electric field that is incident on this dipole antenna, let us say this electric field is E. Now, length of this dipole antenna is lambda by 2, but effective length is something else that I'll explain how to calculate that effective length, effective height. But if I say effective height of this antenna, that is HE, then by multiplying this effective height of antenna with electric field, I can be able to calculate induced voltage in this antenna. So see, if I say because of this electric field, induced voltage in this antenna is V, then that will be effective height of this antenna into electric field incident on it. So ultimately, effective height of antenna that explains how much effective radiation happens. Like say, this is what for reception, but similar case that will happen for transmission. So if I say electric field that falls on this antenna with magnitude E, and if effective height of antenna is HE, then by multiplying electric field with effective height of antenna, we can be able to calculate induced potential in this. So from this, we can calculate effective height of antenna, that is induced potential divided by electric field. So here what we can do is, we can calculate what is the induced potential because of electric field. And if we have idea about what is that electric field which is incident on this antenna, then we can identify effective height. So that is how practically we calculate what is effective height of antenna. Now, how to calculate that based on current distribution? So for that, I am considering two cases. Here I have this dipole of length lambda by 2, and I have second dipole that is having very big wavelength, or one can say length of that second dipole, that is lambda by 10. So if we see current distribution, so this is what current distribution. So if you see this current distribution for half wavelength, current distribution will be somewhat like this. So this is the current distribution which is happening on this dipole antenna. Now how to calculate effective height? So based on current distribution, we can identify effective height. Now see how. So to calculate that, all we need to do is, we need to calculate average of this current distribution. What we need to do? We need to calculate average of this current distribution. So if you see that average, So that will be somewhere over here. Let us say this is what the average line. Now what will be that average line? So that average line will be, if you see, that will be, if I consider this is 1, then what is that average line? So that average, that will be 2 divided by pi. That average will be 2 divided by pi. You just calculate that average of sine, you will be finding it will be 2 by pi. So if you see this value, so that is somewhat 0.64. So this is what the average line, which is there with current distribution. Now from that effective length that we can calculate. So effective length over here, HE, that is this average into length, physical length. So that is this. So effective length for this dipole of length lambda by 2, that will be effective height will be 0.64 into L, and that is coming based on average. So if you see current distribution of half wave dipole, so that will be somewhat this by red color that you can see over here. So that is half wave sine, and its average will be 2 by pi. So that is 0.64. So effective height is 0.64 into L. So see, this is how practically we calculate that. Now second case that I have considered, that is of dipole of length L is equals to lambda by 10. So for that dipole, if you see what is effective height, then for that we need to calculate average. So if you see average, so for this current distribution, this is current distribution. So for L is equals to lambda by 10, current distribution will be triangular current distribution. So for that, if I stretch average line, so that is somewhat this. And if you calculate that average with respect to this maximum, then you will be finding for a triangular, it will be half, 0.5. So that average will be 0.5. So from that, we can calculate effective height, that is 0.5 into L. So this is what effective height based on physical current distribution, which is happening on antenna, and based on wavelength even we can identify what is effective height of antenna. Now in this session I'll be explaining few more things which is regarding calculation based on power. So if I say I am radiating power P with radiation resistance RR, then radiated power, that will be P is equals to V square by 4 RR, where RR is radiation resistance. Now see, here effective height is HE and electric field radiated will be E. So potential V is equals to HE into E. If I place that over here, then you will be finding this will be HE square E square divided by RR. So ultimately that power, that will be HE square E square divided by RR. Now power radiated based on impedance, that we can identify by E square by Z0 E square by Z0 into effective area. This. So this is what even radiated power. And if you compare this, this is for dipole antenna only. So if you calculate, if you compare this to, you will be having effective height formula. So in that case, this square will get cancelled. And HE will be, now it will be in square root. This RR will go in this direction. Sorry, here it will be 4R. So if this will be going in this direction, so it will be 4RRA divided by Z0, where Z0, that is free space impedance, So that will be 120 pi. So it should be clear to all here, this Z0, that is 120 pi for free space. Here radiation is happening in free space. So Z0, that is free space impedance 120 pi. So this is what all about effective height of antenna. So it should be clear to one, like what is effective height of antenna? It belongs to radiation by antenna. So if you multiply effective height with electric field, you'll be identifying induced potential in antenna. So if you multiply effective height with electric field incident, you'll be finding induced potential in that antenna. And secondly, how to calculate effective height? So based on current distribution, we can identify that. So here you can see by this red color, for half wave dipole, that current distribution is this. So average of that will be 2 by pi 0.64. So effective height will be average 0.64 into L. So average of current distribution into actual length, that will be effective height. For similar dipole, but its length is lambda by 10, you'll be finding average will be half. The reason is current distribution will be triangular current distribution, and in that case effective height will be 0.5 L. So physically this is how we can identify. And the basic derivation that I have explained here, this is only true for half wave dipole. For other antenna, you will have to calculate by some other method, where it will be VSWR by 4RR, that is what V is HEE, and that is even square by Z0 AE. And if you compare this two equation, you'll be having AE is square root of 4RR AE divided by Z0, where Z0 is free space impedance 120 pi. So that is how we identify effective height of antenna. Thank you so much for watching this video. I have made this video by a suggestion of one of my friend. He asked to make out this video, and sorry for late reply. The reason is I was busy with some other schedule, but now I'm placing it over here. Hope it will be helpful to you. Thank you so much for watching this video. Keep suggesting based on what videos which is required here. Definitely I'll make out those videos if I have understanding based on your need. Thank you so much for watching this video.